Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time. We are still in 1985. Today, we're going to talk about Monty on the Run. The story of Monty on the Run takes us to Peter Harrop. Peter Harrop is a British video game developer. His first game was Wanted Monty Mole, a platform game released on July 29th, 1984 for British computers. In Wanted Monty Mole, the player plays as Monty Mole, who must travel through a coal mine to collect coal and other items. This was based on the miners' strike of 1984 in the United Kingdom. Wanted Monty Mole would be relatively successful, selling 20,000 copies in the first 6 weeks. This game would be published by Gremlin Graphics, a British publisher founded in 1984 by Ian Stewart and Kevin Norburn, although US Gold's Jeff Brown would own a majority of the company. Wanted Monty Mole would be followed up by Monty is Innocent. Monty is Innocent was instead developed by Chris Carey. In this adventure game, Monty Mole has been sentenced to 5 years in Scudmore Prison for stealing a bucket of coal. The player plays as Sam Stoat, who tries to rescue his friend Monty from jail. The game was significantly different from Wanted Monty Mole and would not be as successful as the original. Peter Harrop would return to design the third game in the Monty Mole series, Monty on the Run. This time, Harrop would get help from Mark Rogers, who designed some graphics, and Rob Hubbard, who would compose the music. Monty on the Run is a platform computer game. The player plays as Monty Mole, who is on the run from the authorities. Monty Mole must escape from his house and head for the English Channel in order to get freedom in continental Europe. Gremlin Graphics released Monty on the Run to British computers on October 25th, 1985. That is a brief backstory to Monty on the Run. With that told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Monty on the Run, written by Tony and Jason of Micro Projects for Gremlin Graphics. It says July 1985. It's unclear whether that's when they programmed it, when it was released. I can't find a lot of information about this game. I will say this is the Commodore 64 version of the game. There's also a ZX Spectrum version of the game. This is a Gremlin Graphics and Micro Projects joint production. And we get some great music and a bit of a story. Thanks to the help of Sam Stoat, Monty has escaped from the hell of Scudmore Prison. Now free to continue his adventures, Monty, must search for a boat to take him to safety. And that's pretty much it. But we do get one extra little thing here. Luck. It says luck. Good luck. All right. The music is awesome. It will loop. We will hear it a ton. But there at the bottom, we have the Monty Freedom Kit. And this is stuff that I have been told, because I can't find a lot of good information about the game. I definitely did not grow up with this game, so I'm going to do what I can. But just know that there are probably a lot of people out there that know better about this game than I do. And what they tell me is that the Monty Freedom Kit is what you need to set up before the game starts in order to make your escape. But what we need to do is select the right things in the Freedom Kit. And I've just been told what the correct answer is. I don't know why. I don't even know what they are. I really cannot find a lot of information about this game anywhere. But what I need to do is I need to pick this one, this scroll-looking thing on number two. Then I need this number four. I believe that's a rope. And I'm hitting left and right, but it's backwards. And down will do what I want. So it's 2, 4, then 12, this book-looking thing, then 13, this gas mask, and then 16 this shield. There's a lot of offensive stuff down here, like this tank and an axe, and there's a gun in here somewhere as well, but those are the ones that you need. 2, 4, 12, 13, 16. All right, let's go ahead and get into the game, and we'll see what we can do. Now, a lot of people do really love this game. You can tell that this was also made for the ZX Spectrum, ZX Spectrum, as a lot of people love to correct me, but that version possibly is the original version. It seems like both of these got released around the same time, though, but most people think that the Commodore 64 has the much better music, so it's the one that I went with. All right, let's go there. That crusher is random. It comes down at random spots. That water underneath us will kill us, so don't do that. All right, let's see if I can do this. Nope. Got hit. Yeah, this is a fairly standard British platform game, I would say. I'm probably going to lose all my lives on this screen. There's, you know, the somersault jump. Precise timing that I fail at because I miscalculated how quickly I was going to fall. It was great music, though. All right, let's go down here. And already things are looking awful for me. Okay, let's try to time that. All right, there. And I can at least get another one up to 200 points. High score is only 2,000. The maximum that you can get in the game, I'm told, is 7,000. So why they have 5 spots, I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, okay. Can I? No. And that's it. That's game over. That's it. I failed. Monty is no longer on the run. He just had everybody destroy him. All right, I got 33rd, and this is where I'm going to cheat. I'm like, that is the best that I have done in all my practice runs, was get 200 and something points, so I'm gonna go ahead and cheat. And the way to do that is something that's built into the game. You just have to type in, and I have to do this very slow because it doesn't always pick up my key presses. But there we go. My name is I Want to Cheat. And now it's the Nameless One. And once you do that, once it resets, there we go, we can hit the button and get back into the game. And I am not cheating yet. I should point that out. Cheating has not started, but cheating is going to be available to me. I'm also told that Siamese could also work as your name, but I don't want to put that one in. I want to put in I Want to Cheat. It makes more sense to me. It didn't do it. It didn't do it at all. It didn't. What did I do wrong? I put it in, right? God, like, you got. I'm down to my last life already because I'm rushing things because I want to try that again. I want to try a cheat. I don't want to necessarily do this again yet. All right. Let me die. As long as I get 100 points, I should be able to try this again. Let me try to figure out what the code is, because I was told that the code was I Want to Cheat. And that should have worked. So let's see here. Yeah. I Want to Cheat. Like I said, it does not. I'm typing it in right. You're just not picking it up. I Want to Cheat. Yes'm boss. That's what I got before to make this work. So I don't know if I typed it wrong. I don't, like I said, I can't really find a lot of information about it. So now let's go in and try it again. Okay. And barely made that. Yeah, in terms of platforming, it is very much in the British style of kind of the flips, and you go quite a distance. There we go. You see that boat? That boat is what I want. So let's land on the boat. And now I am invincible. You might notice that the crusher here does look different. That's because I can go right through it now. And this is how I can beat the game. Like, long story short, without this, not gonna happen. All right, I get an extra life there from the med kit, and then we can actually start having a little bit of fun playing this game. Because for me, at least, it wouldn't be fun without cheating. And that's not usually a good sign. I'm sure there are people that can do this without cheating, no problem. I'm not one of them. And instead of hanging out here trying to make sure I can do all of this properly, I could just put in a code and be on my way. Unless I haven't figured out what to do with. I've encountered that a couple times, but I can't do anything seemingly with it. And now we're already up to 800 points. Just like that. Alright, let's climb up here. There's so many enemies just kind of floating around. And I don't think I can do that. Now this is hard even when you have cheats on. Alright, you got jump. Nope. It screwed up. I'm not used to these controls. It's like Z and X for left and right. And then for me, it's apostrophe and forward slash for up and down. It's just not what I'm used to. There we go. Like, you wouldn't let me climb down. Or up. Up. There we go. I just didn't time it right, I guess. All right, now this is also difficult. I went this way, right? I did. Yeah, I grabbed what I needed out of there. Okay, so let's hop up here just because it makes things a little bit easier. And then, nope, I missed it. You might be wondering, like, didn't you land in it? Didn't you land properly? Yes and no. God, they really don't want me to climb things properly in this game. Alright, so what I have to do is kind of jump on top of it and keep jumping. There we go. And I made it. And these crushers, once again, random. So, hopefully it doesn't just decide to kill you. Oh well. I should be able to get back up there. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. Once again, the water is death, as are all of these enemies. I can grab all of this. Let's see what's, we'll grab the coin, why not? Get me the points. And head this way. And once again, if there are guides, I have not been able to find them. Oh, that. I have heard about that little lift thing there. So I'm kind of avoiding it. And we are on Maple Street. That's kind of important to the overall story of Monty Mole, if you care about that. It's just so difficult. It doesn't look difficult. And that's kind of the part that bothers me the most about it, is it doesn't look hard. It looks like it's something I should be able to do, and then I can't. All right, we're going to avoid that. Pi R square. Huh, I get it. What's up here? Not a lot going on here. Alright, we'll drop down here. There we can get this. A lot of exploring. But yeah, without the cheats... are you serious? Alright. There we go. Not the cheats, like each one of those jumps around the enemies probably would kill me several times. And then they spawn that right at you. Getting that cat was death. Game's not nice. All right, we'll climb down there. Then we'll backtrack a bit because we got a lot of things that we need here. This up here I've been avoiding. That is a teleporter. I don't want to teleport yet, I don't think. Can I not? I don't think I can go back because it's going too frequently. Yeah, there we go. Teleported. Oh, that took me kind of where I was trying to go anyway. Yeah, okay. That's not bad. But yeah, try to do this without invincibility on. Just good luck. Okay, this way. That lift, I am told, is doom. But, I mean, I have kind of infinite lives. Well, it feels like it. Yeah. Instant death. And even with my invincibility, it caused death to me. Okay. Let's try avoiding it. Why are you not climbing? Okay, I was too far inside. How do you get that? How do you get that? How do you get any of this? Is there a way for me to climb up higher here? Maybe. Have I tried up here? Yes. That's where we came from. Okay, I was able to just crawl right through the platform. Fantastic. That's how you do it. Okay. So let's avoid that. That would have been death no matter what I did. You can't do that. Okay, then we can go this way. And this lift I don't think is doom, but let's avoid it anyway. I think it's just the one. And the game has bugged out on me. Fine. Okay, so we're gonna have to come back to this one. I'll do a little bit more work and try to get back to where I was. And, fine. I will let you guys know, and we'll pick up from here next time. That's going to do it for this part of Monty on the Run. Didn't expect this to be multiple parts today, but, that's going to do it for Video Games Over Time. I've been ballerscuba. I hope you laughed. I hope you learned. I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.